Do not attempt to adjust your televisions.
Yes.
You are now watching the most talked about TV show in your city. I'm LB Johnson.
And this is your boy, Buck Dangerous.
And this is Shut Up and Talk
TV. I like how you did that, L.
Yeah, bro, I had to switch it up.
We was on our toes. So yeah. We was really just laughing at something else. But wow. I'm just going to say we was going deeper than ever.
Yeah. Bruh, let me just say, we can't go into too much detail, but
yes.
When we had our radio show, we did a thing called Freestyle Friday. You know, everybody was welcome
yes.
to come to your freestyle spit, both rappers and singers.
Well, we hadn't had a singer
yeah,
yet.
Yeah, for the most part, we've only ever had rappers, but one night we got a singer that came up, and the rest is history, man.
We're going to have to tell that story.
Who was he singing to? Was it Dog?
It was to you.
Oh, no.
He was singing to you.
Said, man, don't sing to me. Sing to the camera.
Bro. Oh, man. We're going to have to tell this. Well, long story short, we found out one of the behind-the-scenes persons is the actual dude that was singing that night.
And we appreciate him and what he does behind the scenes, but we definitely appreciate
just put him this
what
way.
He did that night.
We ain't going to put him in front of no microphone. We know that much. I remember LB was like, Buck, what do you think?
Oh, man.
I just walked off, bro.
I can't wait till we start recording our behind-the-scenes show.
Yes.
The things that happen behind these cameras are, when things mess up, bro, it's monumental.
Right. But I want to say this, though, because we haven't given our thank yous out, bro.
Yeah,
let's go ahead
true.
And give out our thank yous for letting us do our thing in this wonderful studio.
Yeah.
ProView Networks.
ProView Sport Network.
Everybody that's a part of the team, man.
Yes. TIO, the Inspired
One. Yes, sir.
Of course, Boss Man Arrows Independent Studios.
Yes.
Arrows.
Yes.
We found out last week his name is Aaron Jones,
Aaron
right?
Jones.
Okay, yeah, there you go.
I was like, who is Aaron Jones? Did they hire another black dude?
I thought he's one of the brothers, man. Look. of course, DJ Ill Style, man,
yes.
Every week he brings that fire, man.
Yes. Sometimes his shirt don't be on,
look,
but
hey, look,
you know.
He get it how he live, man. I told him eventually we're going to put a mic on DJ Ill Style.
We have to, man.
Because we be going in on him, and I bet believe he be on his breath talking.
He be talking big
noise. So we got to definitely get
in,
man.
The fellas behind the glass, too, man.
Yeah,
we gotta
man.
Give
look,
thank
look.
Got to
shout out Josh, man.
Yes.
Is it Aldine?
Alden.
Alden.
Hey, y'all know I mess up names, man. But them the homies. They the ones that they make sure our shows are edited. They would do all the recording. They are the ones behind the scenes that make sure
they're
Monday,
actually,
Wednesdays, and Fridays we go live.
They're actually our audience in the studio.
Yeah.
So we'll know if we really on and entertaining and saying stuff funny. Because I know y'all can hear it on the show.
Yeah, you just
like,
hear someone
who
yelling.
Who the hell is this yelling and laughing? That's them behind
it. It sounds like somebody in the house has got Tourette's and they're yelling from the back. but that's our producers and the guys behind the
they're doing everything for us, man. So, L, what do you got, man? Well, how are we going to kick the show off? What do we have?
We got to start off by talking about DJ Drama, man. For y'all that don't know DJ Drama, DJ Drama is a world-known DJ. He's an artist on T.I.'s imprint, Grand Hustle.
Grand Hustle.
He's put out a lot of mixtapes. Matter of fact, if you remember, actually, he was one of the first DJs indicted for selling mixtapes, and this was years ago.
Years ago,
yeah. way back in the day when mixtapes was hot and you wasn't streaming.
Right.
But he's in the news for something that has nothing to do with music, and that's taking a bite out of crime. I guess not necessarily crime.
Wait, what?
A crime is a loose word, but taking a bite out of his woman, his wife, his girl. DJ Drama was on vacation, man, enjoying the lovely scenery overseas or somewhere, you know. And all of a sudden, I guess he got into an altercation with his lady. I don't know what happened, what she could have said. I don't know if it was like Dr. Dre's a better DJ than you. Warren G got more bars.
Yeah.
I don't know. But whatever she said, it was that serious where he bit her.
No, that's called self-defense.
Bruh.
Hell, she was whooping his ass. That's what happened. Think about all the altercations you got into.
Yeah, yeah.
You've never got to the point where you were getting your butt whooped or your ass whooped where you had to bite somebody.
If you're fighting, I'm sorry, man, we don't condone domestic violence on the show, but if you're fighting, man, you swinging, whatever.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
So to me, the fact that he bit her on her hand is like, she must have just been throwing haymakers like,
yeah.
And he must have just finally grabbed that finger to
the
eye.
Yeah, bro, she bullied him, man.
Yeah.
He needs to become an advocate for hashtag me too.
Bro, here's the one thing I said, and I put a while back, we put up a post, but we already see these posts about women saying domestic violence is wrong. You know, ladies, it's never okay for your man to beat you, to hit you, to, you know, control you, all those things.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, in this case, we want to flip. We want to say, fellas, if you're sitting in the corner right now, maybe she's kicked you, punched you, wouldn't get you no Kool-Aid. It's not okay.
It's not okay.
Get away from that situation.
Tell someone.
Domestic violence is not love.
Do not resort to biting her.
Look.
Don't resort to biting.
It's okay to nibble. It's not okay to bite.
LB's the only person who smacks when he nibbles.
Hey, bro, look, bro, it's his coolers, man. Look, the way these soup coolers work, bro, look, you just can't help it.
We don't know, man. We making up these scenarios. DJ Drama, she might be, you know, sweet meat or something. You know, he just...
I guess, sadly, you want to believe that that's how it happened. You want to believe she was beating him up. He had to defend himself.
Well, he's a light-skinned fella. I'm going with she was whooping his ass.
Look, and the fact we haven't seen any pictures or any posts like from him, like right. showing his injuries. But sadly, he is charged. He's now facing a charge for biting her. So I hope this is where it gets tough because I know somebody checking out when the police come to the house, they're gonna ask straight up, "Hey,
what
you want to press charges? Yeah. You know who did it?" So if he says, "Man, I didn't do it," he's going to jail.
Yeah.
The fact he wasn't arrested that day means he must have told her, "She hit me again. I was minding my own business."
It's a history.
I was trying to mix a record like Ill Style be doing. And I don't know what she just coke-cocked me and it was a rap.
I wonder, did he put some seasoning on her before he bit her?
Bruh, look.
put some Lowry's on her fist.
How do you react, bro? Like when you T.I., you walk into your DJ, "Hey, man, you know, we got the new."
Yeah, they hard. Good, they bro. Hard men.
You tell them, bro, you know, we got the new the tour coming up, bro. Yeah. You walk in the house, he got a big piece of steak on his eye. Just, "Hey, bro, just give me a little bit, man."
This is what every dude say. "Yeah, I may be messed up, but you ought to see her."
Look, bro. All right, no. Let's be honest. Up until she posted that he bit her and, you know, made it a big deal, he was lying. He said, "No, I was out at the club. You know, dude was tripping out to sock him."
Do you know? So my thing is this, man. Look, fellas, keep your teeth to yourself. You notice I didn't say mouth.
Come on,
keep
bro.
Your teeth to yourself. Stop biting women, man.
Yeah, bro.
Stop biting women, because you might run into Tina Turner. You know what she did to Ike in the back of that limo.
All just running into DJ Drama girl, because evidently she got hands.
Yeah, she was whooping his ass.
Hello,
bro.
Whoa, what's love got to do? Hey, on that note, man, DJ Ill Style.
Take us out, sir.
Hey.
Ready for action, nip it in the bud, we never relaxing. Outcast is everlasting. Ready for action, nip it. Ready for action, nip it in the bud, we never relaxing. Outcast is everlasting. We're not clashing, not at all, but see my went to do a little acting. Now that's for ready for action, nip it in the bud, we never relaxing. Outcast is everlasting. We're not clashing, ready for not at all, ready for action, nip it in the bud.
What is glamour? Frailty. What is desire? Diamonds. They say a life lived without passion is hardly worth living.
Ma'am? Ma'am? Ma'am?
Dang, this one made me feel all special.
Car Crafters, proud supporter of ProView Sports Network.
Are you sure we're supposed to be doing this?
Don't worry, I've watched him do it 1,000 times. Come on, what's the worst that can happen?
No! Bad dog!
Hi, welcome to Car Crafters. What happened?
Don't worry, we'll make it like it never happened.
Car Crafters, it's like it never happened.
Well, I'm going to the frontier, walking to the cashier, order up a root beer and a number one. Cover it with green stuff, one scoop is not enough. Find a booth is real tough, back by the Duke. Meet my family, meet my friends, in the quirkiest restaurant I have ever been. All of Albuquerque's favorite spot, it's the Frontier Restaurant.
The Frontier Restaurant is a proud supporter of ProView Sports Network.
We are back live in the studio right now. We got M.O. Music. Welcome to the show, bro.
Hey, appreciate it.
What's going on, homie?
What's going on?
Good, good, good.
Glad to have you, man. Check it out. You have an extraordinary story.
Bro, his story,
yeah,
man.
Yeah, it's like, wow.
So what we do is we want to make sure that we talk about things that's relevant to your life. Yeah. And we sat down and we were reading. I was like, man, this is like a whole show worth of stuff right
here.
So
here's what I want to do. I want to start off, introduce to yourself, to everybody that's watching at home or whatever. Let's get that out the way. Then I want to dive into who you are.
All right. Yeah, I go by M.O. Music, 27 years old, born in Dallas, Texas, raised in Lansing, Michigan. Been here in Albuquerque about 3 years now.
Okay, for sure.
27 years old.
Bro,
wow.
Now I really feel like it's a lot, because the sheet that we read from A to Z is just a bunch of turns, hills, valleys, all of that stuff.
I'll be 38 tomorrow. If I went through what you went through, bro, I definitely wouldn't be on this show.
You wouldn't
show.
Be here.
Wouldn't be talking about no music. I might be on a show, but it wouldn't be this one. Let's start at the beginning and again, kind of break down the story of your dad for everyone that, you know, of course, it doesn't know.
Yeah. So when I was 3 and a half, he ended up committing suicide in front of me and my mom.
Wow.
Sorry to hear that, man. Yeah.
So that was like basically the point of us moving up to Michigan.
What? So that's like, that happened at 3 years old?
Yeah.
Oh my goodness. So that's basically the backdrop for everything that's going to go forward, right?
Yeah.
Well, as a young man, you know, of course, 3, you're a baby, but as you got older, what does that make you, what do you think, you know, about your dad? What does that make you kind of?
There's like a bunch of emotions, you know. I didn't really know the full story about anything till later on, but, you know, early age, I was always, you know, why didn't my dad want to stick around? You know, why wasn't he a man enough to take care of both of his kids? I got a little brother too and everything. So, but as I got older, you know, I just learned to accept it and everything.
So I do have to ask, before we get into anything else, you know, when you write, you know, just speaking to you, we can feel the emotion and the passion. So is that something that you use to write down lyrics, your songs, your any type of concept that you have for music?
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah,
definitely.
Man.
So, you know, I'm kind of like skipping, but eventually you got into drugs real bad.
Yeah.
Talk to us about that for a minute.
Yeah, so, it just started out with weed, you know, and I just got plugged in. I started selling dope before I, you know, used it.
Yeah.
So, it just came with, basically, I've just taken care of myself my whole life and just got to get how you live, really.
Right.
And I just had so much money, I started picking up Xanax and drinking a lot.
Wow.
No,
I just gotta just piggyback off of everything, because I wanna. You went through so much. Was music? Did you see that as an outlet? And if you did, when did you see that as an outlet?
Well, at first I always played sports, so really I always wanted to, you know, make it playing basketball.
Right,
that was
right.
That was my first option, and then soccer too. But really, probably my senior year in high school is when I really started taking it serious and just put all my emotions, everything into it.
Right. Dang, man. It's LB. Yeah, like, it's usually, no, I want to say this though, Imo, because usually, you know, I don't know if you've seen the show. I know you've heard the radio show. We try to keep it light, but we also have to show this side of not just the show, but also the artist. Because people who don't follow hip hop, they only see the outside. They look at your tattoos, how you carry yourself, your swagger. They don't know that people really do have deep, meaningful story. So we had to get you on the show so you could tell yours.
I appreciate that.
Mm-hmm.
So for you, let me ask you, who's an artist that inspired you when it comes to this music game?
Without a question, you know, being from Michigan and everything too, Eminem.
Yeah.
See, and I knew that because I read that. But but I wanted to say that because we know Eminem went through a lot, you know, when it comes to drug abuse and issues with drugs. For you being a fan of his, when you heard or when it was announced that he was, you know, now, I think when he first announced, he had already been sober like a year.
Right.
Now, did that encourage you, or was that kind of like, he's quitter? Like, how did you feel about hearing that?
Really, I mean, I didn't pay no mind to it at first, no. But recently, you just seen that he's like 11 years sober now.
Yeah.
And that's more motivation for me.
Big.
So I got to ask you, because I know, you know, we keep it, like I said, this is a real heavy show. We want to lighten it up a little bit. What makes you happy besides music? Let's dig into M.O. the person outside of the music. What makes you happy?
Well, I have a 7-year-old daughter.
Okay.
So that's my world.
And that's something me and L.B., we can really relate to, because we're all three of us are fathers up here.
Huge, big on kids.
LB, what are you laughing at, bro? I'm trying to be good over here.
I got to apologize for that, because Buck said we like to keep it light, and then Buck asked, what else makes you happy? And in my head, I'm sorry, but I just imagine you looking at the camera like, bitches.
I was waiting because you couldn't ask me that question.
Bitches,
the ladies. We right down the street from Knockout. So,
but it's good that your daughter. That's definitely better than what I was thinking.
For sure.
Looking at the state of hip hop today, do you think the hip hop is quote unquote dying, or do you think it's just getting started and it's only getting better?
I look at it as it's growing. You know, there's so many different styles. There's multiple, like, so many different ways you can make it and be true to yourself. And mm-hmm. I honestly think there's so many opportunities that anybody can make if they really put the work into it.
I always love asking this question. If you could cancel anyone's record contract right now today, whose would it be?
Oh, that's deep.
If right next to cut that,
just, cut it off.
It's a wrap.
Yeah.
If anybody, if you think everybody's great, that's good too.
I mean, who's what's her name? Bad Baby.
Oh, yeah.
Look,
yeah.
See, we feel some type of way about her because, mind you, when she first came out, she came out as, you know, this badass girl on Dr. Phil.
Yeah, because it wasn't a part of her lifestyle.
Yeah, you know, and so that was bad. So for me, I hate that everybody gave her so much exposure and signed her to record deals and TV shows.
That's what today is about. It's not about the talent. It's about if you could get people's attention.
Yeah. So yeah, I'm in agreement.
Counsel. So what I would do is once you cancel it, they're gonna rewrite it and then we could cancel it again.
There you go. Let everybody know, for you as an artist, as you're coming up, as you're working hard, you're hustling. I definitely see you moving throughout the city and more. For you, when will you know? What does success look like to you? When will you feel like, hey, I finally made it?
When I can buy my mom a house, man. My daughter's set for school. I'm set. Everybody's set. All the people have been rocking with me since day one. It don't matter about a label. I can get that money, you know, exposure on myself.
Yeah. There you go, man.
So what are you currently working on? We got tours. We got the album. What we got going on?
So I actually have an EP that's going to drop on my daughter's birthday, December 16th. That's called Respect My Craft. Hmm. That's all beats by Audio Music, all recorded by Errol.
For the record, Audio Music, that's who does our intro.
Yes.
Hot beats, hot fire.
Fire. And then I'm going to Atlanta December 6th to do a show.
That's big. Sure. Let everybody know how to get in touch with you, bro, if they want more information about MO Music.
You can follow me on Instagram at MO Music Official. That's MO.MusicOfficial, all one word. And then YouTube, MO Music Official, spelled the same way.
Yeah, MO, man, thanks for coming on.
Appreciate you rocking with us, man.
We'll take a break when we come back. A live performance by MO Music.
Ill Style, take us out, sir.
For 1 second, my name is M. Lady. Hi, kids. Do you like violence?
Yeah,
wanna
see
me stick 9 to each one of my eyelids?
Uh-huh.
Wanna my name is what? My name is what? My name is
Don't sacrifice quality and flavor when you're in a hurry. Golden Pride offers ribs, fried chicken, green and red chili breakfast burritos, and Frontier Cinnabuns. Four great locations, or visit us online at goldenpride@abq.com. Golden Pride Barbecue Chicken and Ribs, proud supporter of Pro View Sports Network. Get into the game with Garden Swords Team Sales. They have everything you need, from screen printing, embroidery, and digital printing services, high school letterman jackets, and all high school and club uniforms and individual and team apparel with the most reliable brands like Speedline, Rawlings, and Wilson. And don't forget to check out the latest F7 Shut helmet. It's all at Garden Swords Team Sales. Give them a call, 505-884-1234. Garden Swords Team Sales.
Are you looking to develop your skills this season? Coach Carl Barrere and the Air Barrere program at 8 Grady Sports Performance Center provides comprehensive position training for aspiring football players at all levels. Check us out at 8gradys.com to learn more and sign up for training today.
Shut Up and Talk presents MO Music.
I'm coaching the game.
I'm making dreams reality. You should do the same.
white, call me a Spartan. East side of Lansing, serving dog food in Harper's. Getting turned up with some white girls on that white girl. She gave me cap and gown like she graduated. She only a freshman, with a dope man. I've been hustling, working, investing my money. Now my music is what I'm serving. These hoes, I've been curving. Stay in my lane, these other rappers swerving. This week I be paranoid. I know these haters lurking. My flow on point, damn near perfect. I've been thinking to myself, is a deal really worth it? I ain't trying to sell my soul. These labels keep on searching. I've been doing numbers, yeah, I put the work in. I'm on my way to independent, 100K, I earn this. Blowing up so fast, my vision a little blurry. I apply the pressure, I'm the MVP, call me Curry. I'm the best rapper from Lansing to Albuquerque. I've been doing my own thing, it's better that way. Been grinding my whole life, been making plays. They call me Tom Izzo, the way I'm coaching the game. I'm making dreams reality, you should do the same. I've been doing my own thing, it's better that way. Been grinding my whole life, been making plays. They call me Tom Izzo, the way I'm coaching the game. I'm making dreams reality, you should do the same. I'm not cocky, I'm just confident. Where's all that money and that gun in person? You be photoshopping shit. Boy, you need to stop it. Faking isn't an option for me. 100. You're capping what you're rapping about. Approach me with caution. Listen to your conscience. You're like Beyonce surfboard trying to ride my wave, man. Miss me with that nonsense. I've been doing my own thing.
It's better that way.
Been grinding my whole life. Been making plays. They call me Tom Izzo, the way I'm coaching the game. I'm making dreams reality. You should do the same. I did my time. I earned my stripes. I rolled the dice. Almost lost my life. Made sacrifices.
100.
My future bright. I barely sleeping, working all day and night. Came a long way from a triple beam and serving fiends. I really got it out the mud. Now I'm living my dream. I've been doing my own thing. It's better that way. Been grinding my whole life. Been making plays. They call me Tom Izzo, the way I'm coaching the game. I'm making dreams reality. You should do the same. I've been doing my own thing. It's better that way. Been grinding my whole life. Been making plays. They call me Tom Izzo, the way I'm coaching the game. I'm making dreams reality. You should do the same.
Jackson Compaction wants to help you keep your green
and keep the community green as well.
Jackson Compaction has worked hard to maintain the same prices since day one. Always easy and painless trash removal with professional crews and quality service. If it's non-hazardous waste, debris, or trash on your land, leave it to us. At Jackson Compaction, we're dedicated to ensuring the conservation of our environment.
You trash it,
we smash it. Jackson Compaction, we've earned a reputation for great results.
The New Mexico High School Coaches Association, established in 1941, is an organization of New Mexico's best and most professional interscholastic coaches. Coaches across work daily to help our student-athletes excel in the classroom, on the field of play, and in our communities. Students that participate in interscholastic activities attain higher grades, higher graduation rates, and higher wages. Responsible for the North-South All-Star Games, statewide Coaches Award Program, and providing multiple professional development opportunities for New Mexico's coaches. Be a great coach by coaching beyond the game.
The 2019 New Mexico Sports Hall of Fame candidate nomination voting has begun. ProView Network's president and owner, Steve Davis, has made the nomination ballot. Please go to ProViewNetworks.com, click on Steve's picture, and vote for him today.
In the bag, but I know y'all wanted that 808. Can you feel that bass, babe? But I know y'all wanted that 808. Can you feel that bass, babe?
Yeah, man,
hey,
know what it is.
They caught us.
Look, hey, one of them days when they gonna catch us twerking in this bad boy, man.
They gonna catch you twerking. Mm. Ain't no money on the line.
Look,
I ain't twerking.
Look.
No, I gotta say this though. I'm gonna get serious though. I gotta give it up for M.O., man.
Yeah.
M.O., he came, he had his album on deck. And like me and LB were saying during the break, he's the first artist that has his merchandise on him. So that lets y'all know he is real serious about his craft.
This is our 16th or 17th show since we've been on, since we started Shut Up and Talk TV.
Yes.
He's the first artist to come through and actually give us
his album in hand. Album in hand.
Yeah.
Let's show it up. Man. It's called M.O.
Motivation.
Damn, we're going to mess it up like that.
Motivation.
Motivation 2.
Two.
There we go.
Motivation 2.
There you go.
That's hard, bro.
He's the first one.
M.O. Music, man, doing the dang thing. Man, we just got some breaking news, man. You know, we got breaking news coming in right now.
On BNN.
Yeah, on BNN.
Black Folks Network.
Black Folks, yeah, there you go.
Okay.
It has now been reported that the House representative has started the what is that called?
Impeachment?
Started the impeachment process.
What? Wait a minute. So Nancy Pelosi. They really, okay, so by the time they see this, L, this is probably already going to be on the news.
So this will be,
but we did want to touch on this because I've heard so many other allegations and things about, oh, they're going to try to impeach him and all this
other
stuff.
We've been hearing about it for the last 4 years.
Right. So I guess this Ukrainian story where he went to the Ukraine and had them do investigation on Joe Biden and Joe Biden's son. And then he said, if you guys don't do it, we might take some money from you. Funding. And so the thing is, he admitted to it. So all of the parties, him, Rudy Giuliani, they've already been on TV and said that they did this.
So this is basically, this is, he had them investigate
Joe Biden.
Because he's running for president.
Exactly.
So he's looking for dirt, basically.
Exactly.
And what's weird about that is, first of all, Joe Biden's been vetted. He was already the vice president of the world.
Right.
So it's like, he's been vetted. So I don't think
LB said vice president of the world, Craig. Of the world.
You heard what I said.
Hey, I don't think we should. Let's not let LB vote, man.
Look, bro. Hey, look.
Vice president of the world.
The world, bro. Real talk. Look, United States, same different the world. But hey, my world.
They got jokes behind the window. He said top flight vice president. Not just the regular vice president.
Look,
top
bro,
flight.
Top flight. No, but so I'm like, but he's been vetted. So it's like, I don't know what somebody would find.
Well, because you got to understand, contrary to popular belief, Trump is in trouble, bro.
Yeah.
Now,
no,
I'm not
no
talking
question.
About with the laws or anything.
Russia.
I'm talking about, I'm just talking about him running for 4 more years.
Yeah.
It's a lot of stuff that's come out about him. A lot of people, you know, that are flipping. You got Republicans that's listening to this stuff and they're like, wait a minute. Whoa,
they're
whoa,
be
whoa.
Democrats.
So this is right here. This is what I was waiting on.
Yeah.
Because they've been talking about it. Nothing has stuck. They had the Mueller report. That didn't stick.
Yeah.
Now this right here, as we were reading on break, this looks like it's going to be something.
Trump's in trouble. Like I said, this was just breaking news. So as we hear more about it, by the time you hear this, we'll be about a weekend. So next week, we'll talk about it, let you know the follow-up.
Yeah.
But it was just announced that Nancy Pelosi has announced a formal impeachment inquiry on President Donald Trump.
Man, let's see how it go down.
Look, get Trump out of here.
Let's see how it go down.
Look, hey, on that note.
Hey, get Trump out of here. Keep Shut Up and Talk.
There you go. We ain't going nowhere.
Put us in the White House.
Same time, same place.
I want to be the president of the world, Craig.
LB, D2020. Let go.
DJ, he'll stop.
I feel like that one must stop. Together, nobody talking me.